Hello everyone, welcome to Chong's Real World Data. This is Chong Wang. Today's video is about data import in R. I'm going to show you how to import CSV files, Excel files, and SPSS files into R. After watching this video, you will be able to use R to read your own data. First, I open the RStudio. Next, I'm going to build a R script file. And in this R script window, I can enter my R codes. I will also open a PDF file which includes all the R codes for today's video. You can find this PDF file next to the video. And within the PDF file, all the R codes are shown in the shaded boxes, like here, here, and here. What I'm going to do is to copy the R codes from the PDF file and paste it in the RStudio. And first, I want to import a CSV file. And I'm going to copy the first code from the PDF and copy and paste. And I call this data mydata.csv. You can give your data whatever name you want. For example, you can call it study1 or study.1 or my project, whatever you like. In this case, I want to call it mydata.csv. So I know this is from my CSV file. And I'm using the read.csv function. And we need to modify the file path, like here, as well as the name of the file. And after that, you can see header equals true. It just means that the first row of your data represent the names of the variables. If your data doesn't contain variable names, just put header equals false. Okay. To run the R codes, you need to make sure the cursor is in the line you want to execute. Here, I put my cursor here. You can either use the run button, let's run it, okay, or you can use the shortcut. In Mac, it's Command plus Enter. As you can see in the console window, the code was run twice successfully. If you mess up the code, you will see errors and warnings. For example, here, I changed the file path and run it again. You can see error in file and read the warning message. You can see it cannot open the file because there's no such file or directory. Okay, to import Excel files, let's open the PDF file again. Okay, you need to first install and load a package called readxl. And let me copy all the codes under this section and paste. Okay, let's install the package first. Run. In the console window, you can see it is installing the readxl package. It's done, and we need to load the package. And then we are going to run the codes to import the Excel file. Similarly, I give it a name. I call this mydata.xlsx. And the function is read Excel. After that, that's the file path and the file name. Okay, it seems we have extra space when we copy the code from the PDF. And in this function, we don't have the header option, but we do have a very useful option called sheet. because sometimes you may have multiple sheets within one Excel file, and if you want to specify which sheet you want to read, you can use this option. Like in my example, my Excel file has two sheets and my data is stored in sheet 1. So I specify sheet equals 1. Let's run the code. Okay. It was run successfully. And similarly, to import SPS as data file, we need to install and load a package called foreign. Okay. In the PDF file, copy the R codes and paste. Install the package. Okay, load the package. And I give it this data a new name called mydata.sav. Similar file path and the same name, but here the format is different. And here a different option to data frame equals true. That means I want my R data to be saved in the form of a two-dimensional table, which is consistent with the structure of the original SPSS data. Okay, let's run the code. Okay, this time we receive a warning message, but there's no error. It suggests something to be concerned about. Okay, let's read it. Specifically, it says there are very long stream records in the data. And let me open the original SPSS file. Yes, by checking the SPSS file, I do find some stream variables, like these variables, have very large width values. See here, if you want to take care of this issue, I think you can simply change the width in the SPSS file. Okay. So far, we have introduced the R codes for importing CSV files, Excel files, and SPSS files. If you have multiple data saved in the same folder, you can simplify your codes by setting a default location of files you want to read into R. Like the sample code is also included in the PDF file. Okay, it's under the section how to import CSV files. Copy. Okay, this function is called setwd. It means setting the default working directory. Once you set your default working directory, you only need to specify the file names when reading them. So here I set my default working directory is my sample data. This is the folder path. And after that, if I want to read my CSV file, I don't need to have the full path for the file. I only need to specify the name of the file. Okay. After importing our data into R, it's important to check whether the data is imported correctly. And in this video, I will use the CSV data as an example to show you how to check the accuracy of the data import in three ways. Okay, it's called data checking in the PDF file. First, you can view your data in R using the view function. Run it. Okay, now you can check your data by seeing it. to see whether like the variables are imported correctly. Looks fine to me. Besides viewing your data, you can also check the size of the data. And you can use the dim function. I believe dim function is you run it. It will inform you how many rows and columns are included in the data. And in my case, my CSV file includes 69 rows and 138 columns. You can also check the first and the last few entries. Okay, have my data, CSV. Specify how many rows you want to check. Maybe 5. Want to see the first 5 rows in this data. Okay, it's a little messy here because I have some missing values. And you can also check the last few rows. Okay. So here it looks right to me. Today's video, I talk about how to import data in R. It will be awesome if you can practice these codes with your own data. However, if you do not have a data file at hand, you can use the CSV file that I provide to practice. I also put the data next to the video. And in the next few videos, I will use this data to show you how to clean up the dirty real-world data in R. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.